Welcome, everybody, to Life Coach to the Movies. I'm Noel Murphy.
Welcome, everybody, to Who's Your Coach?
Welcome to the show. I'm Noel Murphy. I'm right there. I may be high, but I'm there. You know, high.
I've been accused of not being available to be really seen.
Sometimes my ma would take a couple drinks and call me at 3 in the morning. And, you know, I think it's important to be there for your folks.
But when a woman says that she's not getting the real me, you know, I say take a closer look. Take a closer look into these eyes.
Dr. Rupert Opie is loved by millions. Those who watch him on public television and attend his seminars are never the same. Take a few moments now for Now Time with Dr. Rupert Opie.
Hi, everyone. I'm Dr. Rupert Opie, talking to you pre-recorded from the Dr. Rupert Opie Institute for the Advancement of Dr. Rupert Opie. That may sound selfish to you, but as you can see, millions of people benefit powerfully from my megalomaniacal pursuit of my own self-importance. So many, in fact, that I get letters from all around the world, many of them saying that I'm so obnoxious that it's a good thing reading my best-selling book, My Wound is Bigger Than Your Wound, Cured My Sister's Depression, because otherwise I'd have shot you, Dr. Rupert Opie, with a deer rifle while you calmly sipped soup from a thermos cup as the setting California sun slowly turned you into a silhouette. Well, cherished viewer, I'm glad too. I'm so filled with myself that I don't ever want it to end. So many times in our lives, we want to be right, but we are constantly being irritated by New Age thinking people who give us philosophies that fly in the face and interrupt the process of truly proving how right we are in life. Well, here, we want to show you some tools to help you be more right than ever. Number one, when being right, raise your voice enough to intimidate the other person. Number two, when you are trying to be right, make sure to let go of any reason or critical thinking of any kind. That'll always get in the way of your rightness. And number three, you yourself should take a leave of any logic at all. Just remember, the most important thing is to be right. Many times when a person's being right, they'll often start getting bogged down with some thoughts about what's the price I'm going to pay here for being right. Am I going to lose my spouse? Am I going to affect my job opportunities? Well, don't let any of that get in your way when you're being right.
Incredible. I'd give that man everything. I actually have.
Buy your copy of Dr. Rupert Opie's best-selling book, A Million Little Book Sales, Lying Your Way to the Top of the New Age Movement. Buy your copy now.
So when you think about it, isn't the delicious feeling of being right so much more important than any sort of long-term results that a person might end up with? Isn't that short-term feeling of gratification emotionally just so far superior to anything that's going to happen later on? I think so.
Turn the camera off.
Once again, thanks for watching. Order lots of my products and we'll see you next time.
Now, it's now time.
Why don't you reinvent your mood for a second, move out of how you feel, and take a look at solely who you know you are.
You know, I think it's what we don't know about ourselves that controls our results. I know that's definitely true for me. Today on the show, we're going to take a look at that idea as it relates to day-to-day tasks. We're going to be focusing on the area I call completion.
If you don't believe that you're totally lovable, even with that you will be a little bit more backed off in your relationship creation process, that you'll be a little bit more withheld, because then it'll be, I will only really put myself out to this particular man if I think, in my unconscious or conscious mind, that he'd love me for
Huffy Mata.
Right. So is there any hesitation there? Because if there is, I'd like you to leave it here today.
Sure.
Leave it here today.
I have a lot. I can recall situations where I have felt rejected. Mm-hmm. Or that he's walked the other way and kind of went into his cave for a few weeks.
Yeah.
He goes away.
He put on his helmet and
yeah.
Got his armor. Jacket and his armor. Yeah. Okay.
And I'm all like, what's going on? Right. You know?
So he met the sting of Joan of Arc riding into battle.
Yeah.
With her martyr sword raised high in a big huff.
And I'm really, I mean, it's all coming from a place of love.
Oh, sure.
No,
or self-protection.
Fear. Yeah.
What I'd like you to do is I would like you to commit to envision a man loving you and accepting you unconditionally, even if he runs for the hills, that he'll be back, that this is part of warts and all.
Okay, he'll be back in a really short amount of time.
In a really short amount of time. In fact, I think that that's an agreement that might get made, which is I leave for 10 minutes or 5 minutes or whatever it would be. That's something you have the opportunity to create an agreement around. But just because you have that stoop does not invalidate the potential or possibility of creating an agreement that makes a little bit of room for the fact you are going to go there.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to go there. It's mm-hmm. going to happen. The idea that it shouldn't happen sets the table, if you will, for, well, he or she might not really love me because here it is, and see, she or he walked out the door.
Mm-hmm.
When actually the agreement is they'll be right back. They just
went
about 3,000 miles for a pack of smokes, and they'll be back in 5 minutes.
Oprah herself got rattled enough to call into the Larry King program last night. To put it this way, we don't all sell 3.5 million copies of our bullcrap.
A gift to be able to put this all together with Noel. He's fantastic. I appreciate everything he has done for us.
Working with Noel Murphy really helped me find my power.
Noel Murphy brings a level of passion and commitment and integrity that I've seen in few people. He is delightfully courageous. He's not afraid to take on whatever is in your way and just knock it aside.
But Noel Murphy starts you at step one. And then instantly jumps you from step one to like step 10 because you bypass all the stuff you normally bring to the table. And for me, that's super powerful.
He does it elegantly and beautifully and with a great sense of humor. He is a doer. He'll take your dreams and turn them into a reality that is bigger than you dreamed possible.
Use Noel. He's wonderful.
Turning around for that one moment to look and see if he actually had shown up. She held the hope that he would, and he didn't. Okay? So, we know how tough it was here. So what's your California? What's your version? Is there something that you've been invited to participate in? Is there a next step that you've been offered, and yet you thought you weren't ready, or were enough, or would screw it up, or for any reason have said no? I invite you to reconsider that and see if it might not be worth making that a yes. And here's the test, which is you've asked yourself the question whether or not you want to do this thing, and I hope you're thinking of something. I hope you're playing along with this. You've asked yourself whether or not you want to do something, and the answer was no. Did you ask that question from yourself in your full power? Janet, your stand is?
Radiant creative idealist.
That means that if Janet's going to ask herself a question in life as to whether or not to participate or do something or make a move or make a commitment or step in, she's going to do it through radiant creative idealist. That's where she's making the decision, not from
Hafimada.
Right. And I invite you to make your choices from that same place. And if you don't know your greatness, give me a call. We'll have a conversation about it. I'd like to thank you, Janet, so much for being on this program.
You're welcome.
Yeah. And let's watch the last scene, Good Will Hunting. Bye-bye for now.